me a mic in the booth. I'm gonna die for the truth. I'm gonna fight for the youth. I don't got nothing to lose. Labels are hiding the proof. Look, I'ma give you a clue. Illuminati symbols are the logos major labels use. Ooh, ayy, finally got that deal.
Pocos animales hay más leales que los perros. Una vez se forma un vínculo entre un perro y un humano, trasciende incluso la frontera entre la vida y la muerte. Es por eso que en este video te presento 5 perros que evitaron robos a sus dueños y a otras personas. Empecemos con el número 5. Este perro se ha convertido en el perro más famoso, luego de evitar un asalto al lanzarse contra 2 hombres que agredían a un despachador de gasolina en la Ciudad de México. Veamos el video. Número 4. Este ladrón se encontró con una sorpresa muy desagradable al encontrarse con un Doberman, perro que posee un sentido innato de la protección y es muy desconfiado con las personas extrañas. Número 3. Este American Pitbull Terrier es el orgullo de sus dueños. En este video demuestra para lo que está hecho, para proteger a su amo y cuidar su territorio. Número 2. Estos perros boxer acudieron en ayuda de su dueño mientras lo robaban afuera de su casa, en Argentina. Se encontraba limpiando su auto antes de ser emboscado por 2 hombres armados. En medio de la conmoción, 2 perros boxer salieron del vehículo para ayudar a su mejor amigo. Número 1. Este hecho ocurrió en Estados Unidos. Un ladrón entró a robar a una residencia, pero no contaba que dentro de la casa estaban 2 de los mejores perros de guardia y protección, como lo es el pastor alemán.
Get your dog!
Si el video te gustó, dale like, comparte y activa notificaciones. Déjame tu comentario para saber qué opinas al respecto. Nos vemos en el próximo video.
So let's see and translate this test, okay, Spanish. So first I translate in English and then I read it in Spanish. So pocos, let me change this to large, okay. Pocos, few. Pocos animales, few animals. Pet, they don't say pets, they say animals. I, this I, it means both there are, and also there here. There, sorry, there is. There are and there is. So it works both for the plural and the singular. In this case, it means there are. Mass, more, more loyal. Loyal, leales is loyal, then, che translate many things, one is then, the dogs, perro is dog, ma here is plural because end up with an S, so is the dogs, okay? So, pocos animales, few animals, hay, there are, más leales que los perros, more loyal than the dogs. Pocos animales, few animals, there are more loyal than the dogs. Pocos animales hay más leales que los perros. Pocos animales hay más leales que los perros. Una vez means once. Once, that, this is a reflexive pronoun, this is no grammar lesson, so I cannot just explain you. Look it up somewhere, it's called a reflexive. Reflexive pronoun, reflexive pronouns that make up, pronouns that make up the reflexive verbs. You make up the reflexive verbs using reflexive pronouns. So, una vez, once, una vez is once, that, se formò, this is the verb formar, make up, form, at the past. So, once he has been created, a bond, vinculo is a bond, between, entre, one dog and a human, this bond, so the subject is the bond, transcend, even, incluso, you can translate in different way, but I will translate even here, the frontier between life and death. Here, clearly, there is a mistake. Voda is a word that doesn't exist in Spanish, I'm sorry, it's vida, okay? This word here is supposed to be a E. So, vida, V-I-D-A, that means life. And muerte is death. So, let's see again the translation. Once that he has been created, a bond between a dog and a human, this bond transcend even the frontier between life and death. It's pretty strong. So let's see how it sounds in Spanish. Una vez que se formó un vínculo entre un perro y un humano, trasciende incluso la frontera entre la vida e la muerte. So, S down here is just is its. In English, you will write its. Es por eso, is because of that. por eso I will translate because of that. So es por eso, it's because of that. That, so che you can translate in different way. Here I translate then because it's used to make a comparison. You have a few animal more loyal than the perros. So it's a comparison. So you translate then, because in English you use then to do the comparison. Instead in Spanish you use que. Que can be translated with which, that, who, in case of people. Ma usually you translate with that. Okay? Is because of that, that, in this, este means this, video in English, you change the accent in Spanish, you say video, te presento. This is the verb presentar, I present you. In Spanish, the subject is mute. Here there is the subject yo, o yo, that means I, and it's there, because it cannot exist a sentence without a subject. It's just implied, it's hidden, but it's there. So it will be yo te presento. This te, it means to you. Okay. So, es por eso que is because of that, that in this video I present you, te presento, I present you. 5, you know Cinco de Mayo, right? Cinco is a 5, number 5. I present you 5 dogs that or which evitaron is the verb evitar, that means to avoid, but is at the past, that avoided robberies. Robo is theft or robberies. They avoid robberies. That avoided robberies to their owners. The dueño, el dueño, it means owner. You can also use the word amo. Evitaron e avoided robberies, I think it has to be, to their owners and to other people. Let's see one more time. Es por eso, is because, let me change the color so you see. Is because of that, that in this video I present you 5 dogs that which avoided robberies to their owners and to other people. Let's see how it sounds in Spanish. Es por eso que en este video te presento 5 perros que evitaron robos a sus dueños y a otras personas. Okay, so let's go to the next. Okay, here it say, empecemos con el número 5. This is the verb empezar. Empezar, that means to start, to begin. So, let's start with the number 5. Empecemos con el número 5. Este perro, you remember, este is this. This dog, this is the reflexive pronoun that you know is about grammar. You have to look it up. So, este perro se ha convertido, this dog, convertir means to change. Ma convertirse, when is reflexive, and this is the reflexive pronoun that show that these verbs is used at the reflexive form. When is reflexive, it means to turn himself into. Turn into. In English, you will say to turn into something. So, this dog se ha convertido. This is the verb conjugated at the perfetto, that in English correspond to the present perfect. Vabbè, anyway. Este perro is a verb that express past. It's called perfetto. Perfetto. And in English is present perfect. It corresponds to present perfect. Present perfect is that verb they say I have eaten. Okay? I have eaten is present perfect. In fact, you say here there is the subject that is implied because the subject is hidden in Spanish. The subject is the dog, it will be él. Él means he, there isn't it in Spanish. So the subject will be él se ha convertido because it's a verb that you gotta use reflexive. So this is something more. Él se ha convertido will be he has turned himself into. Has turned. Because present perfect is this in English. I have eaten. Instead, simple past is I ate. See the difference? Simple past in Spanish you translate with preterito. Preterito is a simple past, I ate. Instead, perfetto is present perfect. I have eaten. So there is a little difference. I have eaten and here is present perfect or perfecto in Spanish. Instead to say he turned himself in, he has turned himself into. Vabbè, anyway. Este perro se ha convertido. So this dog turned himself into the most mas famoso, the most famous dog. Because, you know, the video went viral. So, este perro se ha convertido en el perro más famoso. This dog turned himself into the most famous dog. Luego de evitar un asalto, so after, I will translate after. Luego, I will translate, you translate then, you can also translate with after. Because when you translate, you have to interpret a little bit. You cannot translate word by word, because if it was that easy, nobody will need to study any foreign language. You just need a good vocabulary and translate word by word. You have also to interpret a little bit, because they have many different ways to express. The syntax in a different language. So, luego usually translate then, but I will translate in this case, so with after, that is more appropriate. So, he became a very famous dog after the evitar. Evitar is a verb that means to avoid un assalto. I think you would say in English assault, no? Assalto is assault and a lanzarse means to throw himself and is reflexive with this say at the end. Contra means against dos hombres e contra dos hombres against two men who translate that or who aggredian. This is the verb aggredir. Aggredire means to do an aggression. And this is at the simple past, is this one, is preterito. Two men who, how you say in English, boh, they made an aggression to a despachador. Despachador is seller. De gasolina. Gasolina is gas. So, despachador de gasolina, you know what it is the guy who is in the gas station. Because it means literally, despachador is a seller, someone who sells something. Despachador, seller, de means of gasolina, gas, is gas seller. So, it's the guy who is inside a gas station, despachador de gasolina. And la Ciudad de Mexico. Ciudad means city. Ciudad de México is Mexico City. So, veamos el video. Let's see. Veamos is the verb ver. That is to see. To see. Sorry, I can let me write a little better. I don't know why I write. So, to see. Okay. Ver. So, veamo se il video. Let me do it again here. Okay, let's delete a little bit of stuff. Because it's a little messy. So I read it, I do the translation again and I read it in Spanish again. So it's more clear. Change color. Let's go with the red. This dog turn into the most famous dog after to avoid an assault by himself against two men who attack or made an aggression to a gas station guy in Mexico City. Let's watch the video. Now I read it, okay? Luego de evitar un asalto a lanzarse contra dos hombres que agredían a un despachador de gasolina en la Ciudad de México. Veamos el video. Number 4. This thief, ladrón is thief. Here we have the reflexive again, this is a grammar thing. It's just that some verbs in Spanish works better at the reflexive form. So you just have to look it up how you build the reflexive form in Spanish and which verbs want the reflexive form. You just have to look it up there. So this thief, se incontrò, it means he found, at the past, is encontrar, that is to find or to meet. Sometimes it means also to meet someone. So, to find. So, this thief found with a very unpleasant, muy means very, very unpleasant surprise. This thief found with a very unpleasant surprise to meet with a Doberman, dog that which possess, this is the verb posseer, that it means to have. Un sentido innato. Sentido is instinct. Innato is natural. So dog which had a natural instinct of protection and is very untrustful. It doesn't trust. It's an adjective. It's the contrary of trustful. So untrustful of extraneous person or unknown person. Extraneous means extraneous person or unknown person. So let's translate one more time and then I read it in Spanish. Number 4. This thief found with a very unpleasant surprise a meeting with a Doberman, dog which has a natural instinct of protection and is very untrustful with foreign, extraneous people. Now I read it in Spanish, so you see in Spanish. So, numero 4. Esto ladrón se encontró con una sorpresa muy desagradable al encontrarse con un Doberman, perro que posee un sentido innato de la protección y es muy desconfiado con las personas extrañas.
So let's go to the next.
Okay. Number 3. This,
now you know Este is this, right? This American Pitbull Terrier is the pride, è l'orgoglio, the pride of his, this is the possessive, his owners. The possessive singular is su, plural is sus. And here the possessive is plural because it refers to the owner that is plural. In this video, show, demonstrar, this is the verb demonstrar. So, demuestra, in this video, show, para lo que, because, why, is show, I will translate just why, show why, está hecho. Hecho is the past participle of hacer. The verb hacer means to do, to make. Hecho means also done. So, in this video, show why he has been done, who, the dog. I think is more clear if instead to translate with done, we translate with built. Look, in this video, the subject is the dog. In this video, show why he is built to protect his owner and check his territory. So you show why is this pitbull, the pitbull is a dog that is specifically built for that. So one more time, because I understand that it's not easy. Another language. So, number 3. What a stupid color now here, okay. Number 3. This American Pitbull Terrier is the pride of his owners. In this video, show why he has been built, está hecho, he has been built to protect his owner and protect or check, control his territory. And now in Spanish. Okay. Número tres. Este American Pitbull Terrier es el orgullo. Orgullo, double L, you read Y. Este American Pitbull Terrier es el orgullo de sus dueños. En este video demuestra para lo que está hecho para proteger a su amo y cuidar su territorio. Number 2. Here is plural, it's not this, it's this, plural, because there is the S. So, these dogs, boxer, acudir, this is the past of acudir, it means to run. Acudieron en ayuda, in help, they went to help, this is the possessive and is singular because the owner is singular. So, number 2. Those dogs, boxer, went, ran, to help their owner while, mientras is while. Lo, okay, here there is the hidden subject, they, that in Spanish is ellos, because they don't say the subject, they are implied, but they are there. This lo is a pronoun that it means him and go before the verb. So when you see written lo robaron, it means they robbed him. Robar, it means to steal, to do a robbery. So this is at the past. Lo, it will be they or ellos, that means a, but is implied. That's why I put it into parentheses. When you say lo robaron, it means ellos lo robaron. And this lo means him. So it will be they robbed him, because the syntax is different. So let's watch it one more time. Number two. Those dogs, boxer, went, ran to help, in help is more correct, of their owner while someone or they robbed him. Robbed him. This law is him. Fuera, it means outside. Outside of his house in Argentina. Se incontrava, this is an expression I really don't know how to translate in English, because encontrar is to meet, okay? This se, it can be the reflexive, but grammatically can be also something else. In this case, it's called impersonal subject. Impersonal subject, and is it's something you don't have in English, but just to tell you in a few words, is a subject that is no I, you, he, she, we, you, they. Is another subject that is more generic. It means one. So this is a subject that instead to be a person, like usually is a I, you, is one, someone, everybody, is more generic. That's what it is. You can look it up. So, se incontrava means you can find him. You can find, it was, at the past, it's difficult to translate this. Se incontrava, you could have found it. It means that he was limpiando. This is the verb limpiar, that means to clean. But in Spanish, when a verb end in ando or yendo, so when you see a verb that has this ending, what is this? Is the ing form. In Spanish, you make the ing form using the ending ando and yendo. So limpiar is to clean, but because ending ando is cleaning, is ing form. I don't know why I kind of write, but I try again. Cleaning, okay? So, se incontrava limpiando, you can translate like, it was cleaning. It's much easier in English. It means someone could find that man cleaning his car. Translated perfectly means someone could find this him, because here there is the subject that is implied, someone could find him cleaning his car. But you can just translate, he was cleaning his car. Auto is another way to say car. You know that in Mexico the car is carro, and instead in South America, mostly, most part of South America, like in Argentina, is el coche. Both those two means car in different Spanish countries. Carro in Mexico, coche in Argentina, but you can also say auto, okay? In English you have automobile, no? Ante is an adverb, means before. Before, ante of being, series being, emboscado, ambushed, emboscado, por dos hombres armados, by two armados means armed men. And we, because it's a little difficult, we do it again, okay? Now I'll show you all the grammar, then I do another translation in English and then I read it in Spanish. And medio is in the middle, della commotion. I don't know how I can translate commotion, I will translate action. In the middle of this action, two perros boxer to dogs boxer salieron. The verb salir, it means to leave and also to exit. In fact, if you go in a store in Spanish, there is written salida. Salida means exit. But this is the verb, salir, and is at the past. So, in the middle of the action, two dogs, boxer, exited from the car. Another name for car, vehículo, is another name for car. Para ayudar, this is the verb, ayudar, to help their best friends. Mejor is best. So let's do it once again, because it was a little difficult, this one. So let's do a translation in English one more time. So, number two, those dogs, perros, run in help of their owner while they robbered him outside his house in Argentina. You could find him cleaning his car before to be ambushed by two armed men. In the middle of the action, two dogs, boxer, exited from the car to help their best friend. And now I read it in Spanish. Change the color to blue. Número dos. Estos perros boxer acudieron en ayuda de su dueño mientras lo robaban fuera de su casa en Argentina. Se encontraba limpiando su auto antes de ser emboscado por dos hombres armados. En medio de la conmoción, dos perros boxer salieron del vehículo para ayudar a su mejor amigo. Ok. Number one. This hecho. This is wrong. Sorry, this word is wrong. Is hecho. Hecho. So, hecho, spell with an H, sorry. You read it without H, you say hecho. So, este hecho, this fact, happen, ocurrir. Ocurrir is a verb that is regularly means to happen. To happen, but this is at the preterite, simple past. So, this fact happened in the United States. Estados Unidos are the United States. Un ladrón, ladrón is a thief. Un ladrón entrò, this is the verb entrar, to enter, to steal, robar, to steal, in a residence. Però, but, non contava, contare means expect. Sorry, that, let me write better, contar. Contar, to expect. He has other meaning, the verb contar. It means also to tell or to count, like 1, 2, 3, 4. But in this case, it means he didn't expect. Però non contava, and this is attempts that is called imperfetto. Imperfetto. If you want to learn Spanish, you learn the verbs. They are very important. I think it's the most difficult part. After that, it's just vocabulary. And some grammar, but not much. So, però non contava, but he didn't expect that dentro, inside the house, estaban, there were, this is the verb estar, estar means there were, two of the best dogs for guard and protection, like are, the German Shepherd. Pastor means shepherd. Aleman means German. So let's do again, one more time. Number one, stupid color. I don't know, this is the color that come out all the time. So number one, this fact happened in the United States. A thief entered to steal in a residence, but didn't expect that inside the house there were two of the best dogs for guard and protection, like the German Shepherd. Now let's do read in Spanish. Numero uno. Este hecho ocurrió en los Estados Unidos. Un ladrón entró a robar en una residencia, pero non contaba que dentro de la casa estaban dos de los mejores perros de guardia y protección, como lo es el pastor alemán. Okay, almost done. And then you watch the video and I put the subtitles so you can follow and try to understand. And watch this video two or three times, do this exercise, because this is fluency. If you do a lot of exercise like that, and then you listen to the video, you watch the video with subtitles in Spanish and you try to understand, this is the best way. This is the best way to become fluent. So let's see the conclusion here. See, without an accent means if, because with an accent, it means with an accent is yes, right? So let me take, I don't know right why I wrote accent. With the accent is yes, without the accent means if. If you like the video, te gustó, you liked the video, dale, give it like. This is the English word, you know, on YouTube. Dale like, it means like, thumbs up. That's what they say, dale like, thumbs up. Comparte, this is the verb, compartir, that means to share, compartir. Y activa, activar notificaciones. Activar notificaciones is to activate notification, you know, on YouTube. Déjame. This is the verb dejar. Dejar means to leave. To leave. But, because it's imperative, that is the term used to command. This me, it means to me. And is attached at the verb, because in some cases you attach the pronoun to the verb. So, déjame, it means leave me. Leave me your comment on YouTube. To know, saber means to know. What opina. Opinar, opinar is a verb, it means to have an opinion. In fact, you know, the English word opinion sounds similar, right? Al respecto, about it. Nos vemos is a very common way to say see you. And in the next video. So one more time. If the video you like it, give it a like. And this is an English word. Share and activate the notifications. Leave me your comment to know what is your opinion about it. See you in the next video. Now I read it. See, why come out so big? Okay. See el video te gustó, dale like, comparte y activa notificaciones. Déjame tu comentario para saber qué opina al respecto. Nos vemos en el próximo video. I hope it was helpful. Now watch it with a subtitle. Try to understand. Nos vemos. Ciao.
Pocos animales hay más leales que los perros. Una vez se forma un vínculo entre un perro y un humano, trasciende incluso la frontera entre la vida y la muerte. Es por eso que en este video te presento 5 perros que evitaron robos a sus dueños y a otras personas. Empecemos con el número 5. Este perro se ha convertido en el perro más famoso, luego de evitar un asalto al lanzarse contra 2 hombres que agredían a un despachador de gasolina en la Ciudad de México. Veamos el video. Número 4. Este ladrón se encontró con una sorpresa muy desagradable al encontrarse con un Doberman, perro que posee un sentido innato de la protección y es muy desconfiado con las personas extrañas. Número 3. Este American Pitbull Terrier es el orgullo de sus dueños. En este video demuestra para lo que está hecho, para proteger a su amo y cuidar su territorio. Número 2. Estos perros boxer acudieron en ayuda de su dueño mientras lo robaban afuera de su casa en Argentina. Se encontraba limpiando su auto antes de ser emboscado por 2 hombres armados. En medio de la conmoción, 2 perros boxer salieron del vehículo para ayudar a su mejor amigo. Número 1. Este hecho ocurrió en Estados Unidos. Un ladrón entró a robar a una residencia, pero no contaba que dentro de la casa estaban 2 de los mejores perros de guardia y protección, como lo es el pastor alemán. Si el video te gustó, dale like. comparte y activa notificaciones. Déjame tu comentario para saber qué opinas al respecto. Nos vemos en el próximo video. I'm gonna die for the truth, I'm gonna fight for the youth. I don't got nothing to lose, labels are hiding the truth. Look, I'ma give you a clue, Illuminati symbols are the logos major labels use. Ooh, ayy, finally got that deal, got-